Dr. Jekyll, Miss Lanyon for you.
Good day, Doctor.
Pleasure to see you again,
Miss Lanyon.
I believe you were discussing my research, how we could separate our refined and base natures using chemistry.
Do I understand you correctly? You believe that certain chemicals have the power to change our
bodies and minds?
Yes. They move them aside as wind might move a curtain. And we are born again
as
ourselves, but not ourselves. Do you understand?
Oh, yes. I understand. But Henry, what in God's name make you risk such dangerous research?
You did.
I did?
Yes. You said that we cannot conquer our animal selves entirely. But if I could separate the two sides of our nature, I can breathe into mankind, life anew.
I fear you have gone wrong, Henry. Very wrong.
But my formula is the result of months of hard work.
You have sacrificed everything for your reputation, your laboratory experiments. This idea is unscientific and
even worse, unchristian.
Please, Henry, promise me you will think of this no more.
I promise. I'm going to fight it. No, I promise her. I won't.
Henry?
Miss Lanyon?
Oh. I see.
Miss Lanyon? Miss Lanyon?
Who?
What?
When? Why? What did you see?
I was looking out my window when I saw a man.
Two men, actually.
They were in the street?
What were they doing?
They were traveling down a path.
And between them, I saw a point
where they meet.
The men
turned together, and then
I saw only one.
So what happened
to the other man?
He disappeared.
That's not possible.
I swear, it's true.
And so the tale of J&H, incredible and true. As champions of the sectional, we took the one,
not two.
In prelims we beat one and all, the highest total score. And so we rate as third in state,
and live,
and live, and live.